آسیه قصد ما مرزوم سوار بیه مصایب.
اللهم صل على محمد وآل محمد. اللهم صل على محمد وآل محمد. اللهم صل على محمد وآل محمد. السلام عليك يا أبا عبد الله، السلام عليك يا ابن رسول الله، السلام عليك يا ابن أمير المؤمنين وابن سيد الوصين، السلام عليك يا ابن فاطمة الزهراء سيدة نساء العالمين، السلام عليك يا ثار الله وابن ثاره والوتر الموتور، السلام عليك وعلى الأرواح التي حلت بفنائك، عليكم مني جميعا سلام الله أبدا ما بقيت وبقي الليل والنهار. يا أبا عبد الله لقد عظمت الرزية وجلت وعظمت المصيبة بك علينا وعلى جميع أهل الإسلام، وجلت وعظمت مصيبتك في السماوات على جميع أهل السماوات، فلعن الله أمة أسست أساس الظلم والجور عليكم أهل البيت، ولعن الله أمة دفعتكم عن مقامكم وأزالتكم عن مراتبكم التي رتبكم الله فيها، ولعن الله أمة قتلتكم، ولعن الله الممهدين لهم بالتمكين من قتالكم. برئت إلى الله وإليكم منهم ومن أشياعهم وأتباعهم وأوليائهم. يا أبا عبد الله إني سلم لمن سالمكم، وحرب لمن حاربكم إلى يوم القيامة، ولعن الله آل زياد وآل مروان، ولعن الله بني أمية قاطبة، ولعن الله ابن مرجانا، ولعن الله عمر بن سعد، ولعن الله شمرا، ولعن الله أمة أسرجت وألجمت وتنقبت لقتالك بأبي أنت وأمي. لقد عظم مصابيبك، فأسأل الله الذي أكرم مقامك وأكرمني بك أن يرزقني طلب ثارك مع إمام منصور من أهل بيت محمد صلى الله عليه وآله. اللهم اجعلني عندك وجيها بالحسين عليه السلام في الدنيا والآخرة. يا أبا عبد الله أتقربوا إلى الله وإلى رسوله وإلى أمير المؤمنين وإلى فاطمة وإلى الحسن وإليك بموالاتك وبالبراءة ممن قاتلك ونصب لك الحرب وبالبراءة ممن أسس أساس الظلم والجور عليكم وأبرأوا إلى الله وإلى رسوله ممن أسس أساس ذلك وبنى عليه بنيانه وجرى في ظلمه وجوره عليكم وعلى أشياعكم برئت إلى الله وإليكم منهم وأتقرب إلى الله ثم إليكم بموالاتكم وموالاة وليكم وبالبراءة من أعدائكم والناصبين لكم الحرب وبالبراءة من أشياعهم وأتباعهم إني سلم لمن سالمكم وحرب لمن حاربكم وولي لمن والاكم وعدو لمن عاداكم فأسأل الله الذي أكرمني بمعرفتكم ومعرفة أوليائكم ورزقني البراءة من أعدائكم أن يجعلني معكم في الدنيا والآخرة وأن يثبت لي عندكم قدم صدق في الدنيا والآخرة وأسأله أن يبلغني المقام المحمود لكم عند الله وأن يرزقني طلب ثاري مع إمام هدى ناطق ظاهر ناطق بالحق منكم وأسأل الله بحقكم وبالشأن الذي لكم عنده أن يعطيني بمصابي بكم أفضل ما يعطي مصابا بمصيبتي مصيبة ما أعظمها وأعظم رزيتها في الإسلام وفي جميع السماوات والأرض اللهم اجعلني في مقامي هذا ممن تناله منك صلوات ورحمة ومغفرة اللهم اجعل محياي محيا محمد وآل محمد ومماتي ممات محمد وآل محمد اللهم إن هذا يوم تبركت به بنو أمية وابن آكلة الأكباد اللعين ابن اللعين على لسانك ولسان نبيك صلى الله عليه وآله في كل موطن وموقف وقف فيه نبيك صلى الله عليه وآله اللهم لعن أبا سفيان ومعاوية ويزيد بن معاوية عليهم منك اللعنة أبد الآبدين وهذا يوم فرحت به آل زياد وآل مروان بقتلهم الحسين صلوات الله عليه. اللهم فضاعف عليهم اللعن منك والعذاب الأليم. اللهم إني أتقرب إليك في هذا اليوم وفي موقفي هذا وأيام حياتي بالبراءة منهم واللعنة عليهم وبالموالاة لنبيك وآل نبيك عليه وعليهم السلام. اللهم العن أول ظالم ظلم حق محمد وآل محمد وآخر تابع له على ذلك. اللهم العن العصابة التي جاهدت الحسين وشايعت وبايعت وتابعت على قتله. اللهم العنهم جميعا. السلام عليك يا أبا عبد الله وعلى الأرواح التي حلت بفنائك. عليك مني سلام الله أبدا ما بقيت وبقي الليل والنهار، ولا جعله الله آخر العهد مني لزيارتكم. السلام على الحسين وعلى علي بن الحسين وعلى أولاد الحسين وعلى أصحاب الحسين. السلام عليك يا أبا عبد الله وعلى الأرواح التي حلت بفنائك. عليك مني سلام الله أبدا ما بقيت وبقي الليل والنهار، ولا جعله الله آخر العهد مني لزيارتكم. السلام على الحسين وعلى علي بن الحسين وعلى أولاد الحسين وعلى أصحاب الحسين. السلام عليك يا أبا عبد الله وعلى الأرواح التي حلت بفنائك. عليك مني سلام الله أبدا ما بقيت وبقي الليل والنهار، ولا جعله الله آخر العهد مني لزيارتكم. السلام على الحسين وعلى علي بن الحسين وعلى أولاد الحسين وعلى أصحاب الحسين. السلام عليك يا أبا عبد الله وعلى الأرواح التي حلت بفنائك. عليك مني سلام الله أبدا ما بقيت وبقي الليل والنهار، ولا جعله الله آخر العهد مني لزيارتكم. السلام على الحسين وعلى علي بن الحسين وعلى أولاد الحسين وعلى أصحاب الحسين. السلام عليك يا أبا عبد الله وعلى الأرواح التي حلت بفنائك. عليك مني سلام الله أبدا ما بقيت وبقي الليل والنهار، ولا جعله الله آخر العهد مني لزيارتكم. السلام على الحسين وعلى علي بن الحسين وعلى أولاد الحسين وعلى أصحاب الحسين. اللهم خص أنت أول ظالم باللعن مني، وابدأ به أولا ثم العن الثاني والثالث والرابع. اللهم العن يزيد خامسا، والعن عبيد الله بن زياد وابن مرجانة وعمر بن سعد وشمرا وآل أبي سفيان وآل زياد وآل مروان إلى يوم القيامة.
نسجد ونقول:
اللهم لك الحمد حمد الشاكرين لك على مصابهم، الحمد لله على عظيم رزيتي، اللهم ارزقني شفاعة الحسين يوم الورود، وثبت لي قدم صدق عندك مع الحسين وأصحاب الحسين الذين بذلوا مهجهم دون الحسين عليه السلام. وصلى الله على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله الطيبين الطاهرين. اللهم
صل. القدر صفحة عذابي اللي لي يطويها،
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. وعلم آدم الأسماء كلها ثم عرضهم على الملائكة فقال: أنبئوني بأسماء هؤلاء فقال أنبئوني بأسماء هؤلاء إن كنتم صادقين. قالوا: سبحانك لا علم لنا إلا ما علمتنا إنك أنت العليم الحكيم. قال: يا آدم أنبئهم أسمائهم فلما أنبأهم بأسمائهم قال ألم أقل لكم إني أعلم غيب السماوات والأرض وأعلم ما تبدون وما كنتم تكتمون وإذ قلنا للملائكة اسجدوا لآدم فسجدوا فسجدوا إلا إبليس أبى واستكبر وكان من الكافرين وقلنا يا آدم اسكن أنت وزوجك الجنة اسكن أنت وزوجك الجنة وكلا منها رغدا حيث شئتما وكلا منها رغدا حيث شئتما ولا تقربا هذه الشجرة ولا تقربا هذه الشجرة فتكونا من الظالمين صدق الله العلي العظيم
القدر صفحة عذاب كي القصة حياتي وكي المآسيها قصة موت مرسومة الصور بيها مصايب بيها
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم لا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله العلي العظيم صلى الله عليك يا رسول الله صلى الله عليك وعلى أهل بيتك المظلومين صلى الله عليك يا أبا عبد الله وعلى الأرواح التي حلت بفنائك عليكم مني سلام الله أبدا ما بقيت وبقي الليل والنهار ولا جعله الله آخر العهد مني لزيارتكم السلام على الحسين وعلى علي بن الحسين وعلى أصحاب الحسين الذين بذلوا مهجهم دون الحسين يا ليتنا كنا معكم فنفوز فوزا عظيما بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم وبشر الذين آمنوا وعملوا الصالحات أن لهم جنات تجري من تحتها الأنهار اللهم أرنا الحق حقا حتى نتبعه وأرنا الباطل باطلا حتى نجتنبه ولا تجعله علينا متشابها فنتبع هوانا بغير هدى منك O God, show us truth as true so that we may follow it, and show us falsehood as false so that we may avert it, and do not allow them to resemble one another in our eyes, such that we follow our whims without guidance from you. My dear respected brothers and sisters, Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. This is a night of mourning, a night of sorrow, night of crying. But just as a reminder for all of us, hopefully remembering and taking into account all those things we've discussed, as a reminder for me first and foremost, and for us all, the consequences of not changing for the better are dire. There's just one tradition I want to relay, and then inshallah I'll be done. It's not just that if I know something and don't act on what I know, that I don't benefit. Rather, it can harm me. Rather, it will harm me. It's one thing to say, I know something, I know I ought to pray. I know I ought to follow in the footsteps of Imam Hussein alayhi salam. I know I ought to, and the list goes on. The longer we take to actually act on those things that we all know, the more numb and accustomed and desensitized we become. And we get to a point where it doesn't bother us as much. It doesn't hit home any longer. We may hear a reminder about prayer and just think it's just a cliche, just a traditional talk. As opposed to, and many of us may have such experiences, the first time we make a mistake, our first mistake, it was something unusual for us. We feel a sense of shame and embarrassment. And many of us should be reflecting, and we should all right now be reflecting on those examples that apply to us. Do I feel the same way when it comes to that mistake or that sin now versus when I first experienced it and did it and performed it? And that is the danger. The danger is that we will not feel any longer. The danger is hearing something and us saying, MashaAllah, that was nice, but it has no effect on our behavior, on our lifestyle, on our lives. Imam Zain al-Abidin alayhi salam, who is in mourning tonight, on a night like this, he tells us, إِنَّ الْعِلْمَ He says, مَوْجُودٌ أَوْ مَكْتُوبٌ فِي الْإِنْجِيلِ In the evangel of Jesus, alayhi salam, it is written, "Innal ilma idha lam yu'mal bihi," knowledge, if it is not acted upon, "lam yazdad sahibuhu min Allahi illa بعدا. Imagine. He says, knowledge, that which we know, if we don't act upon it, again, not only will we not benefit, not only are we missing out and losing out on the benefits of those things that God wishes for us, and God only wishes the best for us, and only wishes for us to avoid harms, and those harms come back to harm us, and harm society, and harm our families. Many people may not care about their own well-being, but they'll do anything for their families. Your family depends on this. The community depends on this. If you don't care about yourself, at least care about others. Some may say, even this virus, if I get, you know, ill, inshallah, I'll survive. But will others survive? If you had any sense of empathy, if you feel for other human beings, you would do it for others, at least, if not for yourself. The Imam says, if you don't act upon which you know, that which you know, not only will it not benefit you, it will not increase you except in distance away from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Imagine that the more knowledge I gain and the more I am reminded and I don't act upon it, it's actually harming me. It's distancing me away. At what point will it get to the point where it's too late? Not because Allah will not accept us any further, but because we've dug ourselves a hole too deep to get out of. We pray we are among the true, loyal, sincere, dedicated followers in the truest sense of the word of Imam Hussein Aba Abdullah. As-salamu ala al-Husayn wa ala Ali ibn al-Husayn wa ala awlad al-Husayn wa ala ashab al-Husayn. Subhan rabbika rabbil izzati amma yasifun. وسلام على المرسلين والحمد لله رب العالمين الله القدر صفحة عذابي اللي علي طويها وكيف أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم وصلى الله على سيدنا ونبينا وحبيب قلوبنا أبي القاسم المصطفى محمد وعلى آل بيته الطيبين الطاهرين. السلام عليكم dear brothers and sisters. Inshallah, before we start with the recitation of the saga that will be recited by Sayyid Badr Tajuddin and Brother Jalal Mughniya, before we begin with the recitation, there are a few points that I want to go through just to set the scene for the story that will be told. Now, on these nights, we're here to commemorate an Imam al-Hussein, and we start by passing our condolences to our 12th Holy Imam, Ajallah Ta'ala Farajuhu al-Sharif, to our respected Maraji', our scholars, to all the believers, and especially those that helped in establishing this blessed gathering. Now, Imam al-Hussein alayhi salam, before what happened and what transpired in Karbala, was living in his home in Medina. When the events of Karbala were about to happen, he moved from Medina, he went towards Mecca. And about a month before the 10th of Muharram, he set out from Mecca towards the city of Kufa. Now, he set out to Kufa because there were many petitioners from the city of Kufa that were telling him to come to us so that we can support you and we can help you in your cause. Imam Hussein set out from Medina to Mecca to Kufa because of what was happening in terms of the political system of the Muslim nation at that time. The Khalifa at that point became an individual by the name of Yazid ibn Muawiyah. Yazid was an enemy of the Ahlul Bayt, just as his father Muawiyah ibn Abi Sufyan was an enemy of the Ahlul Bayt, of Imam Ali and of Imam al-Hasan.
And just as Abu Sufyan was an enemy of Ahlul Bayt, an enemy of the Holy Prophet before him. So Imam al-Husayn alayhi salam was faced with a lineage of enemies that came from the time of the Holy Prophet. He set out from Medina, and before he set out, he told his close family members, whoever follows me will be martyred, and whoever does not follow me will not witness the triumph. So on this day, we are reciting the saga that ends in Imam al-Husayn's ultimate triumph in the land of Karbala. Now, as Imam al-Husayn was heading towards the city of Kufa, on the 2nd of Muharram, he was stopped by a small battalion led by a man named Al-Hur ibn Yazid al-Riyahi. He was a general in the army of Ibn Ziyad. Ibn Ziyad was a governor over the city of Basra and over the city of Kufa in modern-day Iraq. Now, if you want to just understand the geography of the time, Imam al-Husayn was heading from the region of Hijaz, which included modern-day Saudi Arabia, the cities of Medina and Mecca, towards the region of Iraq that includes modern-day Iraq and its cities, including Kufa, Najaf, Karbala, Mosul, and other cities in that region. Yazid was stationed in the region of the Levant, in the city of Dimashq. So that's to the west of Kufa and Karbala. So Imam Hussein alayhi salam headed towards the city of Kufa and was stopped by Al-Hur on the 2nd of Al-Muharram. Al-Hur had a battalion of about 500 men. Imam Hussein was leading his family and his companions. His companions numbered about 72 individuals. Narrations say that there were 32 cavalry, 32 individuals with horses, knights with horses, and 40 infantry, individuals on foot. Now, the way that the armies were divided at that time, you had a right flank, a left flank, and a heart, and a standard bearer. The standard bearer is the individual who was the bravest in the army, who was basically the last to fall in times of battle. In Imam al-Hussein's camp, the heart was led by Imam al-Hussein, and the standard was given to Abu al-Fadl al-Abbas. To the right flank was led by Zuhair ibn al-Qayn, and the left flank was led by Habib ibn Mudahir. In Yazid's camp, it began with a battalion of 500, led by Al-Hur ibn Yazid al-Riyahi, and then that number increased little by little. Those 500 became 1,000, then waves of thousands began to join the army, up until they reached the amount of 20,000 or 100,000. Different narrators, different historical accounts tell of different numbers. Of course, at that time, there wasn't really an accurate way of surveying the army. So different narrators, different witnesses of the battle recorded a different number. But let's say either 20,000, 100,000, as opposed to a camp of about 100 individuals. Now, Yazid's army was also divided into a right flank, a left flank, and a heart. The right flank was led by Umar ibn al-Hajjaj. The left flank was led by Shimr ibn al-Jawshan, la'anahullah. The cavalry was led by Uzra ibn Qais, and the infantry was led by Shibith ibn Rib'i. And the standard bearer, the individual that led the heart of the army, was Umar ibn Sa'd. So this army began to gather from the 1st of Muharram up until the 8th and the 9th of, and the 10th of Muharram, starting with the battalion of Al-Hur, and then Umar ibn Sa'd joining as well, and Ubaidullah ibn Ziyad, who was the governor at that time, the governor of Kufa at that time, joined as well. 5 days after that began on the 2nd of Muharram, so on the 7th of Muharram, Umar ibn Sa'd ordered that the water be cut from Imam al-Hussein's camp. And 3 days after that, after the water was cut, was the day of the massacre, was the day that we remember tonight, the day for which we recite the saga on such a night, and for which we shed tears on such a night. So let us welcome Sayyid Abadar Tajuddin and Hajj Jalal Mughniya to begin the recitation of this saga with a loud salawat ala Muhammad wa Ali Muhammad.
Okay.
If I tell you this tale of sorrow, will you lend me your hearts to borrow? If I tell you this tale of sorrow, will you lend me your hearts to borrow? Will you shed a tear for Hussein? Will you remember Zainab's pain? If I tell you this tale of sorrow, will you lend me your hearts to borrow? Will you shed a tear for Hussein? Will you remember Zainab's pain? And if we stay here tonight until tomorrow, will you bear this tale of sorrow? Listen here to Hussein's story, a story of heartache and glory, a story of heartache and glory.
La hawla wa la quwwata illa billahi al-ali al-azim. Inna lillahi wa inna ilayhi raji'un. Salutations be upon you, O Rasulullah. Salutations be upon you, O Commander of the Faithful. Salutations be upon you, O Lady Zahra. Salutations be upon you, O Imam Hassan. Salutations be upon you, O Abba Abdullah. Ya Hussein, Ya Ghareeb, Ya Mazloom, Ya Shaheed. Let's take our hearts to the land of Karbala, to the day of Ashura. It is the 10th day of Muharram in the land of Karbala. In the very early morning, one of the young men would get up and he would recite the call for the prayers.
Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar. Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar. Ashhadu an la ilaha illa Allah. Ashhadu an la ilaha illa Allah. أشهد أن محمدًا رسول الله. أشهد أن محمدًا رسول الله.
With the call for prayer, the 10th day of Muharram commenced. On one side was the camp of Imam al-Husayn. On the other side was the camp of Yazid, Imam al-Husayn alayhi salam, with empathy, with compassion, with the manners of his father and grandfather, he would go forward and he would call on to the camp of Yazid. one last time, one last warning. He would address them, he would tell them, أَيُّهَا النَّاسُ oh people, اسمعوا قولي ولا تعجلوا حتى أعظكم بما هو حق لكم علي. Oh people, listen to me so that I can give you the proof, so that you have no excuse. Oh people, open your hearts, hear me out. They would not listen, his calls would fall on deaf ears. Al-Hussein alayhi salam would continue, he would insist, so that no one has an excuse. He would tell them, oh people, listen to me, for if you believe me and give me what is rightfully mine, we shall depart. Al-Imam al-Hussein alayhi salam attempting to open their hearts and minds to the right path, they would not listen. So then one of the companions of Al-Hussein, Zuhair ibn al-Qayn, he would come forward, he would talk to them, he would explain to them, again, no one listening. Then Ash-Shimr, he would start throwing arrows in the direction of Zuhair. Al-Imam Al-Hussein alayhi salam, witnessing the arrows, he would instruct Zuhair to return to the camp. And then another companion of Imam al-Hussein by the name of Burayr ibn Khudr al-Hamadani, a famous Quran reciter, he would call on them. Oh people, why don't you listen to Imam Hussein? You have called upon him to come to Kufa. Now you're changing your minds. What happened to you, oh people? Al-Imam al-Hussein alayhi salam would address them one last time. He would look in the direction of Umar ibn Sa'd, the commander of the army of Yazid. He would scream out, why don't you lend me your ears? Why don't you listen to me? Don't you remember me? Don't you know who my father is? Don't you recall who my grandfather is? Ayyuha an-nas, I am the son of Ali, I am the son of Fatima. Then he would raise his sword and he would tell them, whose sword is this? He would point to his turban, whose turban is this? No one listens, all of them pointing their swords, their arrows towards Al-Imam al-Hussein.
At this point in time, on the day of Ashura, when all of the soldiers were ready to fight Al-Imam al-Hussein, and when Umar ibn Sa'd was telling his army, now is the time for us to go forward, Al-Hur would come before Umar ibn Sa'd and he would tell him, oh Umar, are you truly gonna go forward into this battle? Are you truly going to kill the grandson of Muhammad? I thought our job was just to keep him here, to prevent him from going to Kufa. Umar ibn Sa'd tells him, oh Hur, this isn't my choice. This is the decision of your leader, your governor, Ubaydillah ibn Ziyad. We're going to war. We're going to battle.
Al-Hur would go back to his tent. He would pace back and forth. Al-Hur, they say he was yellow in the face. He didn't know what to do. So he ascended upon his horse and he began riding away from the camp of Yazid. One of his friends, his companions, would call out to him. He would say, Al-Hur, where are you going? Are you going to attack the camp of Hussein? Are you going to be the first one to launch your attack? Al-Hur would turn to him and he would say, I'm choosing between heaven and hell, and by God, I will never choose over heaven anything. So Al-Hur rides his horse so fast until he reaches Al-Imam Al-Hussein, who's standing at the edge of the camp, looking upon what would be the battlefield. Al-Hur, as he's coming down, ascending, descending from his horse, he throws himself at the feet of Abi Abdullah, and he tells him, Sayyidi wa Mawlai, Ya Hussein, I am the one who stopped you here on the second day of Muharram. I am the one who entered fear into the hearts of the women and the children. I am the one who's caused your misery and your grief. I didn't know it would come to this. I didn't know they wanted your blood. I didn't know what they had in mind. Sayyidi Abu Abdullah, I'm coming before you, repenting to Allah before you. Will you accept me? Will you forgive me? Al-Imam Al-Hussein tells him to rise from his feet, tells him to rise, and he tells him, Al-Hur, your mother gave you the proper name, for you are free in this life and the next. Yes, Allah will repent over you.
Moments before the noon prayers, there stood the army of Al-Imam Al-Hussein, and on the other side, a massive army of Yazid. Umar ibn Sa'd, the commander of the army of Yazid, would call upon everyone. He would grab their attention. He would shout out, Ayyuhan nas, ishhadu li 'inda al-amir. O people, be witness that I will shoot the first arrow at Al-Hussein, that I am starting the war, that I am launching this war against Al-Hussein. So then Umar ibn Sa'd, he would send the first arrow towards the camp of Al-Hussein. The soldiers, after that first arrow is released, they release arrows in the dozens, in the hundreds, towards the direction of Al-Imam Al-Hussein's army. Al-Imam Al-Hussein alayhi salam, from a distance, seeing the arrows coming in his direction, he would call upon his companions, Ayyuha al-Ashab, O companions, قوموا رحمكم الله إلى الموت الذي لا بد منه. Rise to death which is incumbent on you. فإن هذه السهام Salam, Rusul al-Qawm ilaykum. These arrows are the signal from the people of Ibn Ziyad. It is reported that in those moments, the army of Yazid and the army of Al-Imam al-Husayn alayhi salam would engage in battle with each other. A huge cloud of dust would overcome the entire camp. When the dust cleared, it is reported that many of the enemies of Allah were killed. In those moments, one of the companions of Al-Imam al-Husayn, by the name of Abu Thumam al-Saydawi, he would come forward to Abi Abdullah, Sayyidi wa Mawlai, Master Hussein, I see that the people are coming close to you. By Allah, I will not allow anyone to come and approach you. I will die. I will sacrifice myself for you, O Aba Abdullah. Abu Thumama would continue talking to Imam al-Hussein. He would tell him, Sayyidi wa Mawlai, Ya Aba Abdullah, I would love to face my Lord, but before I want to pray, for prayer time has come. Al-Imam al-Husayn would look at him, he would tell him, by Allah, you mentioned the prayer, and this is the time for prayer. Why don't you ask the camp of Ibn Ziyad to pause the war? It is narrated that the camp of Ibn Ziyad would not stop the war, for these individuals did not believe in prayer. They were disbelievers. They were ones that had no faith. They were ones that just wanted to kill Al-Husayn. So then Al-Imam Al-Husayn with some of his companions, they would pray, and surrounding them are some of the companions that stood there to protect them, including Abu Thumam. Abu Thumama was standing there as Al-Husayn was in the stay of supplication, the stay of prayer. And his holy body would receive the arrows from all directions. Abu Thumama would lay on the plains of Karbala. When Al-Imam al-Husayn would finish his prayer, he would come forward to him. Abu Thumama would ask Al-Imam al-Husayn, Sayyidi wa Mawlai, did I fulfill my task? Did I fulfill my duty? Do you accept my sacrifice? Al-Imam al-Husayn would assure him, oh Abu Thumama, yes you did. Then Abu Thumama would send his last greetings to Al-Husayn. As-salamu alayka, ya Sayyidi wa Mawlai, ya Aba Abdullah.
As the battle continued to ensue, as the battle went on, as the battle would continue on the day of Ashura, after the prayers took place and after many companions would fall, Abbas al-Shakiri would go forward before Imam al-Husayn. As the companions continue to fight, Abbas tells Imam al-Husayn, Sayyidi wa Mawlaya ya Aba Abdullah, there is no one closer to me, more beloved to me, more endeared to me than anyone but you on the face of this earth. Oh, beloved Imam Hussein, if I could give anything more important than my own self, then I would give that for you. Ya Hussein, allow me to give my life for you. Give me permission to go forward. Abbas goes into the heart of the battle. This man, known as a great warrior in Arabia, as soon as Abbas walked into the battlefield, at the very center, with all the commotion that took place, with all of the soldiers falling left and right, there was Abbas calling on to the enemies. Oh, enemies of Hussein, come forth and challenge me. Come claim your fame. Oh, enemies of Allah, here I am. Some of them would come forward, and Abbas would slay them right away. The enemies saw the strength of Abbas, and they continued to flee. They continued to run away. Abbas getting upset with the situation. Abbas wanting to fight the enemies, but none of them having the courage to stand up against him. So Abbas calls out to them. He tells them, how dare you run away from me? Don't you want to kill Hussein? Don't you want to bring them pain? Come forth and claim your fame. Abbas, he throws his sword, he throws his shield, he exposes himself, vulnerable on the battle, in the battle, in the land of Karbala. They look at him and they tell him, oh Abbas, what happened to you? Oh Abbas, have you gone insane? Ajuninta ya Abbas, have you gone insane? He says, yes, humb al-Hussein ajannani, the love of Hussein drove me insane, so come forth and fight me. Abbas fought with his bare hands, calling onto them, grabbing them, throwing them. But brothers and sisters, on the day of Ashura, with all of these brave men, with all of these courageous warriors, though they killed dozens, though they killed hundreds, it did not show in their ranks. They surrounded Abbas, this one striking him, this one killing him. They threw their arrows and their spears until Abbas was completely overwhelmed. Finally, Abbas with his bare chest would fall onto the sands of Karbala, and like the rest of the companions, he would call out, As-salamu alayka ya Sayyidi ya Aba Abdillah.
One brave companion after the other, sacrificing for Imam al-Hussein. John, the servant of Aba Dhar al-Ghafari, he was amongst the companions of Ahlul Bayt. This young man would come forward to Imam al-Hussein. He would request from Imam al-Hussein to enter the battlefield and to fight for him and to defend him. Imam al-Hussein alayhi salam would look at John. He would tell him, oh John, you came with us because you wanted to help. Oh John, you did not ask for this battle. Why don't you leave? So then John would look at Imam al-Hussein with tears in his eyes. He would say, Sayyidi wa Mawla ya Aba Abdillah, Master Hussein, Imami Hussein, in the good times I am with you. I eat from your food. I lived in your home. How do you want me to leave in the times of trials and hardships? Never would I do that. I am here for you. I will die in your way. So then Al-Imam Al-Hussein, granting permission to John to enter the battlefield, he would enter, he would fight, he would give everything he had, he would kill some of the evil soldiers, overcoming them, until like all of the other companions, he would be outnumbered, overwhelmed, until he is killed, martyred, slaughtered on the plains of Karbala, sacrificing for his master Al-Hussein.
Another young man, his name was Amr ibn Janada. Amr would come forward and his mother would tell him, "Oh son, why are you just waiting there? Don't you see the companions falling one by one? Didn't you see your father give his life for Hussein?" His mother had dressed him in his armor. She gave him the sword and she told him to go before Imam al-Hussein and ask permission to enter the battlefield. Imam al-Hussein, knowing that he was the only one left for his mother, he didn't want him to go into the battle just yet. So he told his companions to keep Amr back. But Amr managed to escape from their grasp and he leaped towards Imam al-Hussein, pleading with him. He said, "Oh master, allow me to fight alongside you. Allow me to give my life for you." Imam al-Hussein thanked him but told him, "Oh Amr, go back and stay with your mother. You're her only child." Amr said, "Oh Master Hussein, it was my mother who suited me in this armor. It was my mother who gave me the sword. It was my mother who sent to defend you. It was my mother who pleads to Allah, asking for the honor to stand on the day of judgment and tell your mother, Lady Fatima, that she gave her only child for her child Hussein." Dear brothers and sisters, on the day of Ashura, so many stories of young men going forward and giving their lives. The story of Wahab and his wife, who would come on the day of Ashura, newlyweds, these young couple who had just been married hours before, when Wahab wanted to go into the battlefield, his wife was telling him, "Could you stay with me just for a while longer? Could you just stay a little bit more? I'm going to miss you so." Wahab told her, "I have to give my life for Imam al-Hussein. I have to give everything I can for him." So Wahab, in the battlefield, in the heat of the fight, with all of the enemies surrounding him, he sees someone behind him. He looks and he sees his wife approaching. He tells her, "My dear wife, what are you doing in the battlefield? Go back. What are you doing here?" She tells him, "I'm here to fight alongside you. I'm here to give my life with you. I'll never leave you alone." But he said, "Just a little bit ago you were begging me to stay, and now you're here fighting with me. What happened? What changed? What moved you? She said, what I heard back at the camp broke my heart. I couldn't find it in myself to just sit there idly by. He told her, what did you hear? She said, I saw Al-Hussein standing at his tent, looking over the battlefield, saying, wa qillat nasira, where is our aid? Where is our help? Who will come to our aid? Wahab was crying in the battlefield. He calls out, Sayyidi Aba Abdullah, take my wife back. They say that they pulled her back. When Wahab would give his life on the day of Ashura, just moments later, they say that she came back into the battlefield and she stood there looking at her husband. She began crying and weeping. And then a damn soldier close to Shimr would tell, would come forward and strike her on her head and kill her. Brothers and sisters, on the day of Ashura, it wasn't just men that were killed. Women and children were killed alike, husband and wife. And all of them in their last moments would call out, As-salamu alayka ya Sayyidi, wa ya Mawlai, ya Aba Abdullah.
Al-Imam Al-Hussein alayhi salam would look around, and there were only a few more companions alongside him. For most of them have been martyred on the land of Karbala. One of his loyal companions by the name of Muslim ibn Awsaja, he would enter the battlefield. He would battle valiantly. He would fight. He would kill some of the soldiers that would confront him until they surround him. They strike him. Muslim would fall on to the plains of Karbala. He would shout out, As-salamu alayka Sayyidi wa Mawlaya Aba Abdullah. Al-Imam Al-Hussein alayhi salam would hear the call of Muslim. He would rush forward to him, accompanied by another companion of his, Habib ibn Mudahir. Habib would come forward to Muslim. He would place his head in his lap. It is narrated that Muslim, in that state, his body pierced by arrows and swords, wounded in every part, very lightly, very quietly, he would whisper to Habib. He would tell him, oh Habib, I have a will, I have a request, oh Habib. Habib ibn Mudahir would look at Muslim. Imagine that scene, wiping his blood, wiping his tears. He would tell him, oh Muslim, what is your will? Muslim would look at Imam al-Hussein. He would point his finger towards him. He would tell Habib, oh Habib, أوصيكَ بهذا الغريب. Oh Habib, take care of this man. May Allah have mercy on you. Protect al-Hussein, defend al-Hussein. Habib ibn Muzahir, amongst the last of the companions of Al-Imam Al-Hussein. This man, a companion of the holy household, serving with the Prophet, with Imam Ali, with Al-Imam Al-Hassan, and now with Al-Imam Al-Hussein. Even though he was old, he was ill, he was filled with energy. Nothing would stop him in defending his Imam, his master Al-Hussein. He would come and request from Al-Hussein permission to enter the battlefield. Al-Imam Al-Hussein alayhi salam would look at Habib as he's asking for permission. He sees Habib crying, his tears flowing. Al-Imam Al-Hussein alayhi salam, with a heart of compassion, he would look at Habib. He would tell him, "Oh Habib, why are you crying? Oh Habib, do you miss your family? Oh Habib, did you remember your children? Oh Habib, you can go, you can return to your family in Kufa." Habib would answer Al-Hussein. He would say, "Sayyidi wa Mawlai Aba Abdullah, I am not crying for my family. I am not shedding the tears for my children. Oh Sayyidi wa Mawlai, I am shedding the tears for this woman that stands behind you, Lady Zainab. Who will be there for her? Who will protect her? Who will comfort her when all of us are martyred? Sayyidi wa Mawlai, I weep for Zainab." Habib, serving his Imam, his master, he would be martyred on the plains of Karbala. And then following him, more of the companions, the last few, would offer their sacrifice for Al-Hussein. His holy companions, all of them laying slain on the plains of Karbala. Al-Imam Al-Hussein alayhi salam, it is reported that he would go around, he would roam around from one companion to another. He would lay his eyes on Muslim. He would turn and look at Habib, John, Burair, Al-Hur, and he would call upon them, "Ya Habib, Ya Zuhair, Ya Muslim, Ya Burair, I call upon you. Why don't you answer me? Why is it that no one is responding to me?" Al-Hussein alayhi salam, on the land of Karbala, on the day of Ashura, standing alone before the martyred bodies of his companions, yelling out, calling out to the skies, to anyone that would hear him, to any conscious soul, "Hal min nasirin yansuruna?" Is there anyone to help us? Is there anyone to aid us? Is there anyone to protect the family of the Holy Prophet?
No companions left. No one left for Imam Al-Hussein but his own family members. He would turn around and he would see about a dozen men waiting to give their lives for Imam al-Hussein. The first amongst them was his son Ali al-Akbar. Ali would come forward to the Imam, bow his head before his father, and ask him for permission. My father Hussein, allow me to enter the battlefield. And Imam al-Hussein, tears in his eyes, he looks up to the heavens and he says to Allah, "Oh Allah, bear witness on these people that the man that looks so close to your messenger Muhammad is going out into the battlefield." Know that Imam al-Hussein had said, whenever we missed our grandfather Rasulullah, whenever we missed his face, we would look at the face of Ali al-Akbar. So Imam al-Hussein would give permission to his son Ali, but before it he would go to see his mother, who was there praying for him. He kisses her and he hugs her, and he tells her, "I'll be back, my mother." His mother was there praying to Allah, "Please, oh Allah, bring back my son the way you brought back Joseph to Jacob." Ali al-Akbar would go into the battlefield and he would fight valiantly. He killed many scores of the enemies until they say that Ali al-Akbar killed over 100 men. Ali al-Akbar and the scorching sun that he fought under, his armor was weighing down on him. He was growing thirsty. So Ali would go back to the camp after doing so well in the battlefield. He goes back to the camp. Al-Imam al-Hussein is rejoiced to see his son. He tells him, "Oh Father Hussein, the weight of the armor is killing me. The thirst is killing me. Is there but a sip of water so I can regain my strength and go back into the battlefield?" And Imam al-Hussein tells him, my son, it breaks my heart that I can't give you any water, but rest assured, soon you will see our grandfather Muhammad pouring water for you from the heavens." Ali, before going back into the battlefield for the final time, he would go to see his mother once again. His mother rejoiced. She hugged him. She kissed him. But it was only for a few moments. And then he would bid her farewell. Brothers and sisters, Ali al-Akbar would go back into the battlefield. And he would continue to fight on. But the enemy surrounded him, both close and far, launching their arrows, launching their spears, until an arrow hit Ali al-Akbar in the eye, and an arrow hit his chest. Ali al-Akbar trying to hang on, he would grab onto the neck of his horse, but the amount of blood that was coming from Ali al-Akbar would blind the horse. The horse would take Ali al-Akbar into the heart of the enemies, and they began killing Ali. So many striking him, so many around him. He would call out, "Abata ya Hussein." They say to Imam al-Hussein, entered the battlefield like a lion. The enemies dispersed. He found his son, Bunay Ali, Bunay Ali. الدنيا بعدك العفان. When Ali's soul departed his body, Imam al-Hussein looked to the skies and he said, O Allah, this is my son Ali. They have killed him. They slaughtered him. One sacrifice after the other. Imam al-Hussein would be a stranger in the land of Karbala.
Hussein, ya Hussein, Hussein, ya Hussein, Hussein, ya Hussein, Hussein, ya Hussein. O Aba Abdullah, what strength did you have to see your own beloved Ali al-Akbar slaughtered on the land of Karbala? What patience did you have to see your cousins, your nephews, your holy household, their bodies massacred on the plains of Karbala? It is reported that after Ali al-Akbar, the rest of the holy household, Bani Hashim, would start coming out and fighting for al-Hussein, one after the other. They would enter the battlefield. The sons of the Prophet, the sons of Ali ibn Abi Talib, would fight valiantly defending Islam. Abdullah ibn Muslim, Muhammad ibn Muslim ibn Aqil, Ja'far ibn Aqil, Abdurrahman ibn Aqil, Muhammad ibn Abdullah ibn Ja'far, and the rest of Bani Hashim, they would fight, they would defend their master Hussein. And then a young man in his teen years would come forward to Al-Hussein. Al-Qasim, the son of Imam Hassan, would ask his uncle for permission to enter the battlefield. He would come forward. He would request from his uncle, Am ya Hussein, Uncle Hussein, Sayyidi wa Mawlaya Aba Abdullah. It is my turn. It is my time. It is my moment. Let me make you proud. Let me make my father Al-Hassan proud. Oh, Uncle Hussein, grant me permission. Al-Imam Al-Hussein, after initially resisting, refusing to allow his Al-Qasim to enter the battlefield, after Al-Qasim would plead, he would beg, he would grant him permission. So then Al-Qasim, rejoiced, happy, he would rush to his mother, Amla. He would tell her, O mother, give me the sword of my father. O mother, Amla, dress me with the turban of my father. I will go and make you proud. I will fight for my uncle Hussein. So then Ramla, Al-Qasim's mother, she would clothe him. She would prepare him. A mother preparing her son for martyrdom. What patience did you have, O Ramla? May Allah bless you, O Ramla. Imagine this scene where Ramla and Al-Qasim are embracing one another. A mother with her son, a son with his mother, hugging each other, kissing each other, bidding their last farewells. And then Al-Qasim would enter the battlefield. He would announce to the people who he was. He would introduce himself. إن تنكروني فأنا لأجل الحسن صبط النبي المصطفى والمرتان. He would say, if you don't know me, if you deny me, I am the son of Al-Hasan. Al-Qasim alayhi salam would then proceed. He would fight. He would kill some of the soldiers that would come before him. Although he was young, he had the might of his father Al-Hasan, fighting valiantly with courage, with bravery like no other. He would fight until one of the evil soldiers, it is reported, would come from behind him and he would strike him on his head. Al-Qasim would go down. He would shout out, "Aam ya Hussein, Uncle Hussein, Sayyidi wa Mawlai, ya Aba Abdullah. This sacrifice is for you. Accept it, O Aba Abdullah."
All of the members of Banu Hashim had given their lives for Imam al-Hussein. Imam al-Hussein took one nephew after the other, one son after the other, one cousin after the other, until no one was left but one man. No one was left for Imam al-Hussein but his brother Abbas. Abi Fadl al-Abbas was watching, was in the battle, seeing all of his brothers, his cousins, his nephews, one by one giving their lives in this battle. Al-Abbas wanted to go forward and give his life, wanted to take the enemies down. So he tells Imam al-Hussein, "My master Hussein, Sayyidi wa Mawlai." Always speaking to Imam al-Hussein with this respect, always calling him Imami Hussein, Sayyidi Hussein, Mawlai Hussein. Give me permission to enter the battlefield. Let me be your shield. Let me show them who the sons of Ali really are. I will make them scatter all near and far. Abbas, my brother, you're the only one left for me. You're the flag bearer, Abbas. I can't have you leave. Al-Abbas, one time after the other, asks Imam Hussein for permission, but he's denied. So Al-Abbas goes and he sits in his tent, sitting there, waiting for something to happen, waiting for something to change. Who enters the tent to see Al-Abbas? His beautiful niece, Sukaina. Brothers and sisters, imagine the scene as the young Sukaina enters the tent. This niece that her uncle loved so much, she comes to him and she tells him, Sayyidi Abbas, my uncle Abbas, can I see your hand? Abbas gives her his hand. She takes his hand and she places it on her lips. And she says, Am Abbas al-Atash, al-Atash. The thirst is killing me, Am Abbas. Can you get us some water, Am Abbas? Can you help us, Am Abbas? Is there any water for us? Is there any water to help us? They say the more she said water, the more she said al-mai, al-mai. The children heard that word, thinking that there was water. So they all came forward, and they filled the tent of al-Abbas, all crying, al-mai, al-mai, Am Abbas. Lady Zainab came to see what was going on. She's standing at the tent, at the door of the tent, seeing Al-Abbas with the children around him. All of the children crying as Al-Abbas is at the center of them. Am Abbas, al-mai, al-mai. He looks at Zainab, she looks at him. Al-Abbas gets up, he takes Lady Zainab with him. They go to see Imam al-Hussein. He tells him, Sayyidi wa Mawlai Aba Abdullah, if you don't give me permission to continue this fight in the battlefield, then let me go to the river. Let me go get some water for the children. Imam al-Hussein, hearing the children cry, he reluctantly gave permission to al-Abbas. So he ascends his horse and he begins going out towards the river. But who sees him before he leaves? It was Sukaina. Am Abbas, where are you going? Don't leave us just now. She goes before him. She sees he's holding his sword. He's holding his banner. But across his chest is the water skin. Without him replying, she says, Oh, Uncle Abbas, are you going to get us water? Oh, Uncle Abbas, you're getting us water. He says, yes, my dear. The children cheer Al-Abbas as he leaves to the Euphrates River. On his mind, in his heart, he sees Sukaina, he sees the children. Brothers and sisters, at the river there was 4,000 soldiers guarding the water. But Al-Abbas, with all of his strength and all of his might, he was able to maneuver through, he was able to find his way. He struck the enemies wherever they came. He killed a score of the enemies of Allah, getting to the river finally, after fighting through, he descends his horse, he dips his hand to the cold water. Imagine the thirst of Al-Abbas, imagine being without water and fighting. He just wanted one sip. He dips his hand into the water, and then he would stop. Ya nafsu min ba'd al-Husayn huni, wa ba'dahu la kunti aw takuni. Oh, self, oh, self, how dare you rest and drink? Al-Abbas would not allow himself even a sip of water as Al-Imam Al-Hussein continued to be thirsty. So Al-Abbas would let the water in his hands go, and he would let the world know that he will remain thirsty for Imam Al-Hussein. So he filled the water skin, and he put it on his chest, and he got back on his horse. And Al-Abbas was going back to the camp of Imam Al-Hussein. The enemies were waiting for him. Umar ibn Sa'd in the distance saw Al-Abbas moving back. He said, stop him. Don't let him go forward. Don't let him to take water back to the camp of Al-Hussein. He must remain thirsty. Hussein must remain thirsty. By God, if they get even a sip of water, they will destroy you. That's how much they feared Al-Hussein Al-Abbas. So they continued to attack Al-Abbas, but he fought them off. The only way they could get to Al-Abbas was by hiding behind the trees. So a damned soldier would wait for Al-Abbas as he fought some of the enemies, and he would sneak up from behind him. He would raise his sword as Al-Abbas was striking one of the soldiers, and he would cut off Al-Abbas's right arm. Al-Abbas would say, Wallah, in qatta'tumu yamini, inni yuhami abadan an dini. By God, even if you cut off my right arm, I will continue to fight and protect this religion of mine. I will fight for Imam Al-Hussein, this truthful Imam, this grandson of Rasulullah. Al-Abbas continued to fight until another soldier came from behind him and then struck his left arm. Al-Abbas, now with no arms, standing on the plains of Karbala, they began showering him with arrows. An arrow would strike his chest. An arrow would strike his eye. But the arrow that broke his heart was the arrow that hit the water skin. Al-Abbas, trying to reach for the water that flowed from the water skin, but Al-Abbas has no arms. As Al-Abbas began crying, seeing the water flow, a damned soldier came from behind Al-Abbas, and he struck Al-Abbas on his head. Al-Abbas would fall onto the sands of Karbala, and for the very first time, Al-Abbas would call out, Akhi Hussein, oh brother Hussein, aghithni, adrikni, help me, brother Hussein.
Imam Al-Hussein alayhi salam, hearing the cries of Al-Abbas, he would get on his horse and he would storm towards Al-Abbas. He would get down from his horse, descending, then he would walk towards Al-Abbas. Al-Abbas alayhi salam, he can't move, no right arm, no left arm, an arrow in his eyes. He would hear the footsteps, thinking that it was one of the soldiers. He would say, oh man, please don't kill me. I want to see my brother Hussein. This man would answer, Abbas, I am your brother Hussein. Abbas, I am your dear Hussein. Abbas, you broke my heart. Abbas, oh Abbas. Al-Imam al-Husayn alayhi salam, it is reported that as soon as he got to the body of al-Abbas, he would fall down his knees to the ground. Al-Husayn, with all this might, with all the strength, this time he is broken as he sees al-Abbas laying on the sands of Karbala. Then Al-Imam Al-Hussein, he would approach, he would move his hands towards Al-Abbas's head, and he would try to place in his lap. Al-Abbas, with whatever strength he had left, he would move his head from Al-Hussein's lap. Al-Hussein would attempt a second time. Al-Abbas would move his head away a third time. He would do the same. So then Al-Hussein, looking at Al-Abbas, he would tell him, oh Abbas, brother Abbas, Habibi Abbas, why is it that you move your head back from my lap? Al-Abbas would tell Al-Hussein, oh brother Hussein, Akhi Hussein, I can't allow my head to be in your lap for a few moments. Which lap would your head be placed in? How can I rest in your lap when your head won't be resting in any lap? Oh Abbas, do you know what will happen, dear brother Hussein? Do you know that his whole head will be beheaded? Do you know that his body will be trampled? So then Al-Imam Al-Hussein, in those moments, what can he say? What can he do? His tears flowing, looking at Al-Abbas. Then it is narrated that Al-Abbas, talking to Al-Hussein, he would make a request. He would say, Akhi Hussein, Habibi Hussein, I have a request for you. Oh Abbas, what is that request? Brother Hussein, I don't have a left arm. I don't have a right arm. Oh brother Hussein, please wipe the blood from my eyes, for I want to see you one last time. I want to look at your holy face. I want my eyes to lay on your eyes. I want to see you wipe the blood from my eyes. Oh, brother Hussein. Al-Hussein would wipe the blood from Al-Abbas's eyes. Al-Abbas barely seeing Al-Imam Al-Hussein. They were there. Al-Hussein submitting to the will of Allah. Seeing his brother, his flag bearer, his backbone, slain on the plains of Karbala. He would attempt to hold him, to lift him, so that he would return him to the camp. Al-Abbas, noticing that Al-Hussein is attempting to lift him, he would say, Sayyidi, Aba Abdullah, I beg you, keep me here. Don't lift me. So then Al-Hussein would tell him, oh Abbas, let me take you back to the camp, to Zainab, to the woman, to the children, to your dear ones. Al-Abbas would refuse. He would say, no, brother Hussein, I beg you, don't take me back. back. How can you take me back without the water? I promise Sukaina water. I promise the children that I will quench their thirst. I can't return empty-handed. Oh, brother Hussein, I did not fulfill my promise. Leave me here. Keep me here. Al-Hussein alayhi salam, weeping over the body of Al-Abbas, until Al-Abbas would bid his last farewell to Al-Hussein. His soul would depart. Al-Abbas is martyred. Al-Abbas is killed, returning to his Lord. Al-Imam al-Hussein alayhi salam, fulfilling the request of Al-Abbas, he would leave him behind. He would get up. He would head back to the camp. As he's walking, broken, for the first time, Aba Abdullah, the son of the Lion of God, Ali ibn Abi Talib. All the tragedies that he has witnessed, all of the hardships that he has endured, this one was different. This one broke his heart. It broke his back. It killed everything in him. Al-an inkasara dhahri. My back is broken. My flag bearer is gone. Abbas is martyred. Al-Hussein alayhi salam would return to the camp. The woman, the children, Sukaina, anticipating his return. When they see him coming forward, walking slowly, broken, Sukaina would look at her father. She would say, oh father, Abi Hussein, where is Al-Abbas? Where's my uncle? Al-Hussein would not talk to anyone. He would not answer Sukaina. He would not answer the calls of the children. He would go forward to Al-Abbas's tent. He would go and he would grab and he would take down the pole of his tent, signaling his death. As soon as the children would see Abbas's tent falling to the ground, they would shout out, they would yell out, Wa Abbas, Wa Abbas. Sukaina would be yelling out, Am ya Abbas, Uncle Abbas, Am Abbas, Uncle Abbas.
Al-Imam al-Hussein looks at his women and his children as they're calling out, Wa Abbasa. He looks at Lady Zainab and he tells her, Oh Zainab, Oh Fatima, Oh Sukaina, Oh Ruqayya, my farewell is to you now. The women know that Imam al-Hussein is the only one left for them now. الإمام الحسين with his back broken, with his heart broken. He tells Lady Zainab, my sister Zainab, bring forth my horse, for now it is time for me to enter the battlefield. Lady Zainab tells him, what sister brings her brother the horse of death? They're all crying, they're all wailing. Lady Zainab, the guardian of the women and the children, she tells them, come forward and say your salam to Imam al-Hussein. And now the cries turn from Wa Abbasa to Wa Husayna, Wa Husayna, Wa Husayna. Sukaina looks at her father, Imam al-Hussein, and she says, Abba ya Hussein, have you surrendered to death? With tears in his eyes, he tells her, my daughter Sukaina, when I am left all alone, when the enemies surround me, when Abbas is gone, when Al-Akbar is gone, when Al-Qasim is gone, when my companions have fallen, what else can I do? She holds on to him, she calls him, she says, Abba ya Hussein, take us back to the place of our grandfather, take us back to Medina, take us back home. Imagine Sukaina holding on to her father, saying, please take us back home. Imam al-Hussein, crying with his daughter, he tells her, my dear Sukaina, hold your tears for now, for you will cry so much after me. They say, brothers and sisters, as Imam al-Hussein was about to ascend on his horse, he saw Imam al-Zain al-Abidin come forward. Remember Imam Zain al-Abidin, the son of Imam al-Hussein. He was sick on the day of Karbala, on the day of Ashura. He could not fight in the battle. But in this moment, when Imam al-Hussein spoke of his loneliness, Imam Zain al-Abidin would come out from his tent on a cane, dragging his sword in the sand. He comes forward and he says, Abba ya Hussein, I am here for you. Abba ya Hussein, I will protect you. And Imam al-Hussein embraces his son, crying. He says, Umm Kulthum, please take my son Ali back to the tent. For if he is killed, then there will not be an Imam after me. All the women crying, all the daughters crying. Will you cry with the daughters of Hussein? Wa Husayna, Wa Husayna, Wa Husayna.
Hussein, ya Hussein, Hussein, ya Hussein. Al-Imam al-Hussein, sacrifices on the land of Karbala were endless. Which ones can you count? How many were there? One sacrifice after the other. It is narrated that Imam al-Hussein had a young infant by the name of Abdullah with him. This young infant was thirsty. He had not drank water for 3 days. It is reported that Imam al-Hussein alayhi salam, before he would enter the battlefield, Lady Zainab would come and she would bring the infant Abdullah, this beautiful young boy, and she would hand him to Imam al-Hussein. Imam al-Hussein would hold his son in his arms, looking at him. This young boy, thirsty, tired, exhausted, he would look at him with tears in his eyes, and then he would go towards the battlefield. He would hold him high so that the soldiers of Yazid would see him, carrying him in his arms. He would talk to them. He would shout out to them. He would tell them, إن لم ترحموني فرحموا هذا الطفل. If you don't have mercy on me, have mercy on this innocent infant child. Imam Hussein would continue. He would tell them, your problem is with me. You want to kill me. What does this little boy have to do with it? For he is an infant. He is innocent. So then it is reported that amongst the soldiers of Ibn Ziyad, there was commotion. There was a debate. Some soldiers would say, this is an infant child. Give him water. Other soldiers would say, no, don't give him water. Kill his father's heart. Don't give any water to the household of the Prophet. So then Harmala, a damn soldier, one of the leading soldiers of the army, he would receive a request from Umar ibn Sa'd. Umar ibn Sa'd, after seeing the arguments, he wanted to end it. He would look at Harmala. He would tell him, oh Harmala, Harmala, iqta' niza' al-qawm. Oh Harmala, oh Harmala, end the dispute. So then Harmala, he would look at al-Husayn. He would take an arrow. He would target Abdullah, eyeing him, targeting him. He would shoot the arrow towards Abdullah. The arrow would strike him. Al-Imam al-Hussein holding on to Abdullah. The arrow striking his neck. The blood gushing. Abdullah cries out. And then he is silent. Al-Imam al-Hussein would take the blood and he would throw it to the skies. He would say, Allahumma taqabbal minna. Oh Allah, accept this in your way. Oh Allah, accept this sacrifice. Oh Allah, be a witness for this tragedy.
Imam al-Hussein prays to Allah, saying, it was made easy that all of this is in the sake of you. It was made easy for me because you see me. Imam al-Hussein returns to his camp with his baby boy dead in his hands. He gives the baby boy to Lady Zainab. And they bury his baby boy alongside his brothers. Al-Imam al-Hussein, with all of this heartache, he looks at Lady Zainab once more and he tells her, now is the time that I must go and give my life in the way of Allah. But Lady Zainab tells him, oh brother, mahlan, mahla, yabna zahra, mahlan, mahla, yabna zahra. O son of my mother Fatima, wait before you go. I have something to give you. Lady Zainab embraces her brother. She hugs him. She kisses him. She looks to the heavens and then she says, oh mother Fatima, oh mother Fatima, I have returned the trust to you. And Imam al-Hussein tells Lady Zainab, what do you mean, O Zainab? What trust do you speak of? She tells him, O Hussein, do you remember when we were children? Do you remember when the ribs of our mother Fatima were broken? أتذكر من البتول والضلوع المكسرة. Do you remember when our mother, in her last days, she took me to the side? She held me, she hugged me, and she kissed me. And then she did it once more. I asked her, oh mother Fatima, why did you do this twice? She said the second time, my daughter Zainab, wasn't for you. This was for your brother Hussein. When you grow older, there will be a day, the day of Ashura, in the land of Karbala, where I won't be there for your brother Hussein, but you will be there. You will hug him, you will kiss him, and you will give this to him from me. Al-Imam al-Hussein embraces Lady Zainab and they cry together, whispering the name of their mother Fatima. Wa Fatima, wa Fatima.
Inna lillah wa inna ilayhi raji'un. عظم الله لكم الأجر. May Allah reward you, all lovers of Hussein, remembering the tragedy of Aba Abdullah, remembering al-Hussein. It is reported that al-Imam al-Hussein, after bidding his farewell to Lady Zainab, he would enter the battlefield, entering like his father, Asadullah al-Ghalib, Ali ibn Abi Talib, entering with the might of his grandfather, Muhammad. No one would stop him. No one would confront him. Anyone that came in his way would be killed. Al-Hussein alayhi salam would go to the right flank, and then he would go to the left flank, and then he would go into the heart of the enemies. No one can stop him. No one would stand a chance before Aba Abdullah. Al-Hussein عليه السلام would kill scores of soldiers, and then the soldiers, knowing that no one would be able to stop him, no one would be able to confront him, even in a bunch, no one would be able to exchange with Al-Hussein. They plot to throw rocks at him, arrows. Dear brothers and sisters, in those moments, the evil soldiers from all directions, from the right flank, from the left flank, before him, behind him, they would shower him with rocks, they would throw arrows at him. One of the arrows would strike Abu Abdullah on his forehead. Al-Imam Al-Hussein would take the blood and he would wipe his head with the blood. He would look at the soldier that threw the arrow at him. He would tell him, by Allah, I will face God this way and I will tell him who did this to me. Al-Imam Al-Hussein alayhi salam, still riding his horse, receiving more arrows. An arrow strikes him in the waist. Another arrow strikes him in his leg. And then a three-prong arrow strikes him in the chest. Abi Abdullah Al-Hussein, his body penetrated with arrows from every direction. And then the Imam alayhi salam, still trying to hold on to the horse, but with more arrows, with rocks, he loses his energy. Every part of his body is wounded. He would fall from the horse to the sands of Karbala. He would say, Bismillah wa billah wa ala millati Rasulillah. Al-Hussein alayhi salam, falling onto the sands of Karbala. The evil soldiers would surround him, they would circle him, they would come forward with their swords, they would strike Abu Abdullah one after the other, in the tens, in the dozens, merciless, they would strike Abu Abdullah. In every part there was a wound. Al-Hussein laying there on the plains of Karbala, all he can do, all he can say is La hawla wa la quwwata illa billah.
They say Imam Al-Hussein, when he lay on the grounds of Karbala, his nephew Abdullah ibn al-Hassan, a young boy, was watching the scene from the tents. He said, I will come protect you, my uncle Hussein. He was able to escape from the grasp of the women. He ran down to his uncle Hussein. He threw himself onto his master Hussein. Al-Imam Al-Hussein calls out to Lady Zainab, Ukhta Zainab, come bring this child. They will kill him. One of the cursed soldiers see this young boy sitting by his uncle Hussein. He raises his sword. Abdullah tells him, oh cursed man, do you want to kill my uncle Hussein? Abdullah blocks his strike, but with his arm, and this young boy is left with no arm. And Imam Al-Hussein is crying. Abdullah, this frightened boy. He is then struck on his head and he is killed alongside Imam al-Hussein.
Imam al-Hussein's body laid on the sands of Karbala. Imagine the scene, dear brothers and sisters. Oh, those that are shedding the tears, mourning al-Hussein, remembering his tragedy. Aba Abdullah, his holy body laid on the sands of Karbala. The evil soldiers, the vicious enemies of Allah, they would surround him, they would circle him, but no one would dare to come and kill him. No one wanted the blood of al-Hussein. No one wanted to claim killing the grandson of the Prophet. So then, as the scene continues, al-Hussein, with pain and agony, every part of his body is wounded with arrows in every part of his holy body, laying there. As he lay there, his horse would come forward. Umar ibn Sa'd, from a distance, he would see that. So then he would tell the soldiers, this is a special horse. Let's see what he has. What is he gonna do? So then the horse would come forward to Aba Abdullah. He would wipe his head with the blood of Aba Abdullah. And then he would go back to the camp of al-Hussein. Who would receive him? Who was there that would see the horse? Sukaina, Ruqayya, the children, they would see the horse. And as soon as they saw the blood on the horse, they would shout out, Abata, Father Hussein, Abi Hussein, Father Hussein.
Lady Zainab would then go down to Imam al-Hussein. She would want to see him for the very last time. As she rushed down to see Abi Abdullah, Umar ibn Sa'd would command his soldiers to move away. He would say, everyone stop. Do you know who this lady is? As she walks barefoot on the sand, Hi bint Zahra, Hi bint Ali, move away, move away. They say Lady Zainab would come down to Imam al-Hussein. She would throw herself on him. Imagine her heart. What does she do in these last moments? They say Lady Zainab looked at Imam al-Hussein and then she raised her head to the heavens. Allahumma taqabbal minna dhal qurban. Oh Allah, accept this from us. As Lady Zainab is weeping, she tells Imam al-Hussein, Akhi Hussein, Habibi Hussein, نورعيني يا أبا عبد الله. كلمني, speak to me. Imagine Lady Zainab just trying to hear the voice of her master Hussein, her brother Hussein. She says, by the right of our father, our grandfather Rasulullah, speak to me. Imam al-Hussein doesn't say anything. She stresses, she says, Brother Hussein, talk to me by the right of our father Ali. He doesn't say anything. Then for the third time she says, Akhi Hussein, kallimni bihaq yummina Zahra. Talk to me by the right of Fatima. Imam Hussein tells her, Ukhayya Zainab, wallah, you've broken my heart. Ukhayya Zainab, you've added to my misery. Ukhayya Zainab, please go back to the women and children. Ukhayya Zainab, go back. Leave me here. Leave me here.
Take your hearts to the land of Karbala. On a day like this day, the greatest tragedies of all. Inna lillahi wa inna ilayhi raji'un. La hawla wa la quwwata illa billahi al-aliyy al-azim. Lady Zainab, after bidding her brother her last farewell, she would walk away. Al-Hussein remains there by himself. The soldiers would surround him, but no one would dare to kill him. So then Umar ibn Sa'd, may Allah damn him, he would yell out, "Inzulu wa arihu," kill him. None of the soldiers would respond. No one would reply. No one would answer except Ash-Shimr, this evil soldier. May Allah damn him. Ash-Shimr, responding to Umar ibn Sa'd, he would tell him, "Oh Umar, I will kill Hussein. I will finish Hussein. I will claim his blood." So then Ash-Shimr, he would come and he would sit on the chest of Imam al-Hussein, sitting on the chest of Abu Abdullah al-Hussein alayhi salam. He would look at Ash-Shimr with arrows in every part of his body. He's butchered, he's massacred, cut to pieces. He would look at Ash-Shimr and he would tell him, "Oh Shimr, do you know me, oh Shimr? Oh Shimr, do you know who I am?" Ash-Shimr tells him, "Yes, oh Hussein, I know who you are. I know you're the grandson of the Prophet. I know you're the grandson of Ali ibn Abi Talib. I will kill you." So then Ash-Shimr, may Allah damn him, sitting on the chest of Al-Hussein. Oh lovers of Al-Hussein, mourn your Imam, cry over your Imam. Ash-Shimr takes his dagger, he strikes Al-Imam Al-Hussein 12 times, cutting his body one after the other. He would strike his holy body 12 times, and then he would hold his head, he would take the dagger, and he would be at the Imam alayhi salam.
وحسين 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 وحسين. Call upon him,
call upon your Imam. For our living Imam al-Mahdi alayhi salam is calling upon his grandfather. We know that for a fact. For once, let's be with our living Imam. Let's do what he is doing. Let's call with him on al-Husayn. Wa Husayna. Wa Husayna.
في الطفوف تسبى زينب للعين وتنادي أين أنت يا معيني. في الطفوف تسبى زينب للعين وتنادي أين أنت يا معيني. وحسينا 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 وحسينا
وحسينا وحسينا.
في الطفوف تسبى زينب للعين وتنادي أين أنت يا معيني. وحسينا
وحسينا وحسينا
وحسينا
وحسينا.
والحسين دون رأس بالدماء دون ستر وثلاثا في العراء. والحسين دون رأس بالدماء دون ستر وثلاثا في العراء. وحسينا وحسينا
وحسينا
وحسينا
وحسينا وحسينا.
رأس مولى لا برمح قد تسامى يقرأ القرآن نورا وسلاما. رأس مولى لا برمح قد تسامى يقرأ القرآن نورا وسلاما. وحسينا وحسينا
وحسينا
وحسينا وحسينا
وحسينا.
زينب تدعو اليتامى أن تعالوا. زينب تدعو اليتامى أن تعالوا. من طغاة لا تخافوا لا تبالوا. من طغاة لا تخافوا لا تبالوا. وحسينا
وحسينا وحسينا.
Call with Lady Zainab.
وحسينا وحسينا.
Call with Sukaina.
وحسينا
وحسينا
وحسينا وحسينا.
قاتلوا العباس غدرا وهو حامي. قاتلوا العباس غدرا وهو حامي. كان ظهرا وعضيدا للإمام. كان ظهرا وعضيدا للإمام. وحسينا وحسينا
وحسينا وحسينا.
Lady Zainab.
وحسينا
والسكينة.
وحسينا
with the children.
وحسينا وحسينا وحسينا.
في الطفوف تسبى زينب للعين و
وتنادي أين أنت يا معيني في الطفوف تسبى زينب للعين وتنادي أين أنت يا معيني وحسينا
وحسينا وحسينا وحسينا وحسينا
وحسينا
يا الله يا الله يا الله يا الله بحق محمد وآل محمد بحق الحسين بحق الحسين بحق الحسين اللهم ارزقنا زيارة الحسين اللهم ارزقنا شفاعة الحسين اللهم ارزقنا خدمة الحسين Oh Allah, by these sincere tears, grant us the opportunity to visit Aba Abdullah in the land of Karbala. So that we can mourn him under his dome, holding on to his shrine. Oh Allah, grant us the intercession of Aba Abdullah. Oh Allah, give us the opportunity every year to serve Aba Abdullah. We ask you, Allah, to accept this humble service by these tears, Ya Allah, to accept our a'mal, our deeds, to cure all of our ill ones, to fulfill all of our needs, and to hasten the reappearance of our beloved Imam al-Imam al-Hujjah. Allahumma kun liwaliyika al-Hujjah ibn al-Hasan. صلواتك عليه وعلى آبائه في هذه الساعة وفي كل ساعة وليا وحافظا وقائدا وناصرا ودليلا وعينا حتى تسكنه أرضك طوعا وتمتعه فيها طويلا برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين وصل يا ربي على محمد وعلى آل بيته الطيبين الطاهرين
اللهم صل على محمد وآل محمد اللهم صل على محمد وآل محمد اللهم صل على محمد وآل محمد السلام عليك يا أبا عبد الله السلام عليك يا ابن رسول الله السلام عليك يا ابن أمير المؤمنين وابن سيد الوصين السلام عليك يا ابن فاطمة الزهراء سيدة نساء العالمين السلام عليك يا ثار الله وابن ثاره والوتر الموتور السلام عليك وعلى الأرواح التي حلت بفنائك عليكم مني جميعا سلام الله أبدا ما بقيت وبقي الليل والنهار يا أبا عبد الله لقد عظمت الرزية وجلت وعظمت المصيبة بك علينا وعلى جميع أهل الإسلام وجلت وعظمت مصيبتك في السماوات على جميع أهل السماوات فلعن الله أمة أسست أساس الظلم والجور عليكم أهل البيت ولعن الله أمة دفعتكم عن مقامكم وأزالتكم عن مراتبكم التي رتبكم الله فيها ولعن الله أمة قتلتكم ولعن الله الممهدين لهم بالتمكين من قتالكم برئت إلى الله وإليكم منهم ومن أشياعهم وأتباعهم وأوليائهم يا أبا عبد الله إني سلم لمن سالمكم وحرب لمن حاربكم إلى يوم القيامة ولعن الله آل زياد وآل مروان ولعن الله بني أمية قاطبة ولعن الله ابن مرجانا ولعن الله عمر بن سعد ولعن الله شمرا ولعن الله أمة أسرجت وألجمت وتنقبت لقتالك بأبي أنت وأمي لقد عظما مصابيبك فأسأل الله الذي أكرم مقامك وأكرمني بك أن يرزقني طلب ثارك مع إمام منصور من أهل بيت محمد صلى الله عليه وآله اللهم اجعلني عندك وجيها بالحسين عليه السلام في الدنيا والآخرة يا أبا عبد الله إني أتقرب إلى الله وإلى رسوله وإلى أمير المؤمنين وإلى فاطمة وإلى الحسن وإليك بموالاتك وبالبراءة ممن قاتلك ونصب لك الحرب وبالبراءة ممن أسس أساس الظلم والجور عليكم وأبرأوا إلى الله وإلى رسوله ممن أسس أساس ذلك وبنى عليه بنيانه وجرى في ظلمه وجوره عليكم وعلى أشياعكم برئت إلى الله وإليكم منهم وأتقرب إلى الله ثم إليكم بموالاتكم وموالاة وليكم وبالبراءة من أعدائكم والناصبين لكم الحرب وبالبراءة من أشياعهم وأتباعهم إني سلم لمن سالمكم وحرب لمن حاربكم وولي لمن والاكم وعدو لمن عاداكم فأسأل الله الذي أكرمني بمعرفتكم ومعرفة أوليائكم ورزقني البراءة من أعدائكم أن يجعلني معكم في الدنيا والآخرة وأن يثبت لي عندكم قدم صدق في الدنيا والآخرة وأسأله أن يبلغني المقام المحمود لكم عند الله وأن يرزقني طلب ثاري مع إمام هدى ناطق ظاهر ناطق بالحق منكم وأسأل الله بحقكم وبالشأن الذي لكم عنده أن يعطيني بمصابي بكم أفضل ما يعطي مصابا بمصيبة مصيبة ما أعظمها وأعظم رزيتها في الإسلام وفي جميع السماوات والأرض اللهم اجعلني في مقامي هذا ممن تناله منك صلوات ورحمة ومغفرة اللهم اجعل محياي محيا محمد وآل محمد ومماتي ممات محمد وآل محمد اللهم إن هذا يوم تبركت به بنو أمية وابن آكلة الأكباد اللعين ابن اللعين على لسانك ولسان نبيك صلى الله عليه وآله في كل موطن وموقف وقف فيه نبيك صلى الله عليه وآله اللهم العن أبا سفيان ومعاوية ويزيد بن معاوية عليهم منك اللعنة أبد الآبدين وهذا يوم فرحت به آل زياد وآل مروان بقتلهم الحسين صلوات الله عليه اللهم فضاعف عليهم اللعن منك والعذاب الأليم اللهم إني أتقرب إليك في هذا اليوم وفي موقفي هذا وأيام حياتي بالبراءة منهم واللعنة عليهم وبالموالاة لنبيك وآل نبيك عليه وعليهم السلام اللهم العن أول ظالم ظلم حق محمد وآل محمد وآخر تابع له على ذلك اللهم العن العصابة التي جاهدت الحسين وشايعت وبايعت وتابعت على قتله اللهم العنهم جميعا السلام عليك يا أبا عبد الله وعلى الأرواح التي حلت بفنائك عليك مني سلام الله أبدا ما بقيت وبقي الليل والنهار ولا جعله الله آخر العهد مني لزيارتكم. السلام على الحسين وعلى علي بن الحسين وعلى أولاد الحسين وعلى أصحاب الحسين. السلام عليك يا أبا عبد الله وعلى الأرواح التي حلت بفنائك. عليك مني سلام الله أبدا ما بقيت وبقي الليل والنهار. ولا جعله الله آخر العهد مني لزيارتكم. السلام على الحسين وعلى علي بن الحسين وعلى أولاد الحسين وعلى أصحاب الحسين. السلام عليك يا أبا عبد الله وعلى الأرواح التي حلت بفنائك. عليك مني سلام الله أبدا ما بقيت وبقي الليل والنهار. ولا جعله الله آخر العهد مني لزيارتكم. السلام على الحسين وعلى علي بن الحسين وعلى أولاد الحسين وعلى أصحاب الحسين. السلام عليك يا أبا عبد الله وعلى الأرواح التي حلت بفنائك. عليك مني سلام الله أبدا ما بقيت وبقي الليل والنهار. ولا جعله الله آخر العهد مني لزيارتكم. السلام على الحسين وعلى علي بن الحسين وعلى أولاد الحسين وعلى أصحاب الحسين. السلام عليك يا أبا عبد الله وعلى الأرواح التي حلت بفنائك. عليك مني سلام الله أبدا ما بقيت وبقي الليل والنهار. ولا جعله الله آخر العهد مني لزيارتكم. السلام على الحسين وعلى علي بن الحسين وعلى أولاد الحسين وعلى أصحاب الحسين. اللهم خص أنت أول ظالم باللعن مني وابدأ به أولا ثم العن الثاني والثالث والرابع. اللهم العن يزيد خامسا والعن عبيد الله بن زياد وابن مرجانة وعمر بن سعد وشمرا وآل أبي سفيان وآل زياد وآل مروان إلى يوم القيامة.
نسجد ونقول:
اللهم لك الحمد حمد الشاكرين لك على مصابهم. الحمد لله على عظيم رزيتي. اللهم ارزقني شفاعة الحسين يوم الورود.
القدر صفحه
العذاب.